you're seeing kind of generations of, or a generation emerging of young men who are emerging without any chance to really get a profession or skilled labor, who are in a workforce where there is no longer a chance for a blue-collar union job that might at one time have propelled them up the ladder. And I think that is a, I think it's kind of the opposite of the problem in the rest of the world. I think we have to figure out better ways of addressing the boys who don't get engaged in school, who lag behind in reading. 2/3 of the members of the National Honor Society in American high schools are girls. That's a different issue, longer issue. So I take your point about inequities and challenges right here in the U.S. I wouldn't put education in that category. And lots of rooms to continue that debate, argue about other issues, but there's a reception. I think there's a good reception right outside. Is that right?
One more question. One more question. Really quick. My hand is shaking. Thank you for being here. I sent you a link about Reed's protection of rapists from criminal investigations from our also criminal police who also sexually harass and have a notorious reputation. So could you speak about that or university rapes in particular?
Oh, or about what
rapes? University rapes in general. Brain garbage.
Somebody tweeted me a link about, which was the first I knew about the campus issue here, so I can't proclaim myself an expert on the Reed situation. I would say, though, that there does seem to have been a real problem on a number of campuses around the country, and more broadly, not just campuses, but with kind of attitudes. And I think Steubenville kind of exemplified that. And that it's not, the degree to which people have been, in some ways it is similar to what happened in the world, and then the degree to which one intends to blame the victim, find excuses for the young men involved. And I think that there has been, in much of the U.S. culture of impunity for these young men. And I think the way that's going to change is if more of these cases are prosecuted. And I also, what is striking again is this isn't, it's not a gender battle. It's not that, men have one kind of attitude and women another. If you look at the attitudes on Steubenville, on domestic violence, it's not that men are in favor of it and women are against it. There's a modest gender difference, but it's pretty small. And there are an awful lot of girls in high schools around the country who think that girls was to blame. And I think that the way to address this is to have a lot of conversations. I think it's to have people talk about their experiences. And I think that is something that is incumbent upon us to